Well, let's pivot to Bitcoin here. It's been on a wild ride this year, up 170% as investors use digital currency as a hedge against global risk. But with Bitcoin losing steam in the last few months, down almost 12% since its peak in June, what's the catalyst for the next leg higher? Let's check in with none other than Tom Lee, co-founder and head of research at Fundstrat Global Advisors, who joins us from a conference here in New York City. Tom, great to have you with us.
Yeah, good to see you guys.
What will take it higher at this point?
Well, you know, I think that there have been tailwinds building for Bitcoin. You know, one has been obviously, you know, sort of institutional money potentially coming in through things like Bakkt and programs like Libra. But and the technicals have been better. But I think Bitcoin has kind of stalled recently because the macro outlook is stalled. I think in a world without trend, Bitcoin doesn't go up. So I think the next big catalyst is, I think, is a decisive breakout in the equity markets, because I think once equities break to an all-time high, Bitcoin becomes a risk-on asset.
So you need the equity markets to hit an all-time high for Bitcoin to hit all-time highs.
Yes. In fact, we published a piece today just showing our clients that if you look at the you know, in the last 10 years and take the three or four best years of the S&P, they've all coincided with the best years for Bitcoin. So Bitcoin does best when the S&P is up more than 15%.
So this whole notion of Bitcoin being a hedge against risk, does that go out the window then? Because presumably, I mean, I guess you can go either way, because we've climbed to record highs despite risk at this point. But at some point, risk could catch up with the markets, and
well,
how does that play into
yeah,
Bitcoin's
or
edge?
Or Bitcoin may be ambidextrous, you know, that it works well in a risk-on world, but as you start to get nervous, then you treat it like digital gold. What we had in the summer was neither environment. It was a market that looked like it was on the precipice. It looked like it could fall, but it never did, and I think stuck in that trend was bad for Bitcoin.
Okay, so if markets go to record highs, where does that bring Bitcoin to?
Well, I think that this starts to sort of bring back into the narrative that if markets make a new all-time high and we see central banks still supportive, it's kind of good for liquidity. So there's sort of liquidity going into Bitcoin, and more importantly, if there's an interest in acquiring some volatility, that's where you're going to see people buying Bitcoin.
Is your prediction that the markets will, in fact, go to record highs?
I think that we're inching closer. So our base case has been for a second-half rally in the S&P 500 to greater than 3125. All-time high is around 3025. I think we're going to surpass that soon, and it would be bullish for Bitcoin.
So, Tom, it's an interesting concept, and we've seen a lot of macro funds starting to use Bitcoin as that hedge. In 2017, though, when the stock markets hit new highs, the altcoins rallied. So is it more potential that the altcoins rally than Bitcoin, or is this a Bitcoin-centric rally?
It's kind of come through in the conference. You know, I think there's a bit of sobering around alts, just more in that some are useful. They're not really sure how to trade the whole group. So I think what may end up playing out is S&P hits an all-time high. Bitcoin reaches an all-time high, which is not too far away for Bitcoin. And then I think it would likely lead to the start of alt season. So I think you'd want to see an all-time high in Bitcoin.
Tom, thanks for joining us. Good to see
Great.
You.
Thanks for having
Tom
me.
Tom Lee of Fundstrat. How do the charts look? Do you see an all-time high for Bitcoin?
The chart's good, and I want to hit on something Tom said.
Yeah.
I don't think Bitcoin's about risk off. Bitcoin's about liquidity. And in an environment where money is ample and rates are low, you see liquidity expressions in equities, and I think you see it in Bitcoin. I would expect a new high here. Whether it goes to 20,000, I don't know. It's consolidated here in a bull's fashion. It's above an upward sloping 200-day moving average. I like it as an expression of liquidity.
Yeah. I listen to Brian Kelly with laser focused, and recently he said there might be one move to the downside, maybe 8,500. And what he said, and I'm going to say this carefully, a generational buying opportunity.
That's right. Stand by that. I think you're going to have a massive buying opportunity here. We may have already seen it in the 9,000, so yeah, I might be trying to be too cute with this, but there's too much money coming into this market. You're going to have an opportunity to have a generational buy in Bitcoin sometime, I would say in the next 6 months.